This is the Sainlogic 5-in-1 outdoor weather station. Let's take it out of the box. So here's everything that you get in the box. You get, of course, the base station here. You can power that from the included adapter. This is desk mountable, as you see, or wall mount. So you see on the back of it, a little stand there, two holes right there for wall mounting. If you want, you can run this off of two AAA batteries, like that. You have some buttons here, and some buttons on top, as you see, like that. So that's your base station where everything is going to be displayed. They give you a full user manual. Also, quick setup instructions, front and back. Tells you how to mount it and that, and I'm going to go over that right quick for you. Over here is the outdoor sensor and its mounting hardware. So over here you have screws and you have bolts with nuts on them, as you see like that. So they give you all the hardware that you're going to need. You get this plastic rod, which is the rod that's going to hold the base station, and that mounts to this. And you have two different installations. So you can do one of two things here. Let's just say that you have a flat surface you're going to mount it to. You can place that there. This will then go in there, and then the outdoor station will go atop that. So that's one option. The other option is if you have a pole already sticking up, then you can use this together. And you see how it has these cutouts. So it'll be like a pipe, for example. And of course, that'll be spread for the diameter of the pipe like that. And then in doing that, you then have this mount where the rod will go in to raise it up over here. And the outdoor sensor itself has all kinds of really neat looking stuff. This is a rain cup over here, wind speed. There's actually a little bubble level right there. Wind vane, which tells you which direction, and of course built-in temperature, humidity, all that. So you'll see all these things spinning around and doing all kinds of stuff. The click in there is normal. That is a function of the rain gauge here. So pretty much what you would do, let me set this up. You see, I'm going to plug that in there and plug that in there. And in doing that, this would be rigidly mounted, and the outdoor sensor on this nice sturdy pole or rod like that. And that way it can do what it's supposed to do out there. This does require AA batteries, so you do need to install those. This will only work on battery power, so that does mean yes, eventually you're going to have to change the batteries in it. So with all of that fancy gadgetry, what do you get? What does it display? What does it actually tell you? Well, it tells you a whole host of different items. Like I said, it has a rain gauge that'll measure the rainfall. Weather forecast. Now, the weather forecast, so you're aware, is going to be based on barometric pressure. So that means that as soon as you plug this in and get everything working, you're not going to have a forecast. It's going to come in over the next day, 2 days, 3 days, as it senses trends in pressure in that. And then it can give you an idea what the weather might be the next day based on the barometric pressure trends as such. Of course, it's going to display the temperature and the humidity, both indoor and outdoor. It'll tell you the current air pressure, basically your barometric pressure. There is a wind vane that'll tell you which direction and how fast the wind speed is. And it also tells you the moon phase. So if you're at a quarter moon, half moon, three-quarter moon, full moon, or a new moon, anything like that, it'll tell you. And this will transmit up to 328 feet. So as long as the base station is within that range, it should be able to pick up the signal from it without any problem. We're going to see it a little later after I get this mounted up. I'm going to do a temporary installation just to show you how it works and the data, and we'll see the screen. But it purports to have a very clear color screen that could be seen even from the angle. So we'll take a look at that. So now I'm going to go ahead and mount this up temporarily, and I'll show you what I'm doing just for this test so you can get a better understanding of how it's mounted. So real quick to install, what I've done is I have this board of wood over here. I've just clamped to my picnic table out here. I put this bracket on here, started two screws. You would put four in over there, so it's very securely mounted, but like I said, this is just temporary. The corner holes on this bracket piece have indentations, and that's if you're going to be mounting to a pipe or something like that. Now, I can't show you everything here because otherwise this review is going to be an hour long and nobody would watch it. So some of these things are going to be self-evident, such as these holes that are there, and there are holes on the side of this bracket, and they give you really small nuts and bolts to ensure that a huge gust of wind won't blow it out of there. So like I said, some of these things are just going to have to be self-evident. This goes together, so we'll pop that down in. I've already placed batteries in the compartment here, and I can mount the weather station on there, and look at it go already just with the wind, as you see. So we'll tip that up so you can see a little better. The wind vane showing the direction and the wind speed up there. Rain catcher is ready to go for catching rain if that should come by. And now we'll go back to the indoor sensor. So I've had this plugged in for just a little bit now, and the only thing that I had to do was set the date and time. That's all I had to do as far as it picking up the outdoor sensor, and that it just worked right away. You plug it in, can take several minutes for it to come in. For me, it came up within under a minute for sure. So it shows the year up here, time and the day. Here's your moon phase. Also, you can adjust the brightness. So I'll leave it back at the highest brightness. Over here is the wind. Gust 5.8, average 4.9. This is in miles per hour, as you see there. And it just changed. And it also shows the direction there. So this is not going to update, you know, every single second or constantly or anything. It does it about four times a minute or so. Over here is your weather. In fact, it just changed again. Over here is your weather forecast. It is a nice, bright, sunny day right now, and indeed, flowers are growing. Over here, your barometer. Now, you can adjust these units. This was miles per hour. You can adjust that to units that you're more familiar with, such as meters per second or anything like that. This is inches of mercury, INHG, and that, of course, can be changed as well. Rain. Well, it's a sunny day, so there's no rain. So that's showing zero for now. And over here, it's a sensor. Temperature outside, 79.9. And the arrow, you'll notice, is going straight out. And that means that it's been constant. And, you know, again, 79.9 to 80.1 is not going to change the curve of that arrow as such, because it's such a minor change. It'll vary throughout the day. And your outdoor humidity indoors is 72.9. That's remained pretty constant because it's climate controlled in here, and 42% relative humidity. You also have minimum and maximum. There's a button right on top you can press, and that'll show you that. So you can see the minimum of temperatures and wind speed and all that stuff, and the maximum as well. There's also alarms that are built into this. Now, this is something that you're going to have to sit down with the book and figure out if you do indeed want this feature. And basically what it's going to do is, let's say if you have plants outside or something like that, you can set an alarm for the outdoor temperature. So when it reaches, say, 85, it'll alarm to let you know that it's reached 85 degrees. And as such, you'll know to either bring them in, put them out, water them, what have you. Or you can do it for any of the other functions that are here. So you can set that up if you'd like. And as far as setting that up, of course, you get the book, which is right here. The book is in absolute plain, well-written English. There's nothing to leave any doubt or question in your mind. It's all right there for you. So an excellent outdoor 5-in-1 weather station from Sainlogic. If you'd like to purchase this item, I'll leave a link in the video description where you can find the item available for sale on Amazon. Thanks for watching. Make sure you click like, make sure you click subscribe, and take care. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.